Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the FL Studio series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. Today I want to show you how to record your vocals because FL Studio is kind of difficult in understanding how to record your vocals if you're not used to it. So firstly, what you want to do is have your interface set up. Go to your options, go to your audio settings and set up your audio interface so that you have an ASIO driver selected, A-S-I-O. So that you can record in FL Studio. Once you have your ASIO driver active, you want to go to a track, any track you want, click up here, select your microphone input. It's going to be different based on how you have your interface set up, so it's not always the same. That's why I'm skipping over the specific settings there. Then you want to load any plugins that you want. I just added a couple effect plugins, but you don't hear them yet. Now you hear the plugins, and I'm going to be recording into those plugins. Now to record, you just click on your microphone source. Make sure you arm the disc for recording, okay? Now stay on this track or else FL Studio will do something else. I don't know why it's set up this way. It can be a lot easier and more simplified. But anyway, we're not here to complain. But now you wanna go to your playlist option and I'm gonna record over this track. So let me turn on my effects. Now if you don't like hearing your voice, like if you don't like hearing your voice and you hear that small delay, you can click on your microphone input, go to your master track and click the up arrow, but you won't hear me. So you can see I'm talking, but you won't. So that means you can sing without distracting yourself or hearing a delay. Also, they've added an input delay. This is why you need to upgrade to FL Studio 20. They fixed a lot of issues, especially timing issues. So you can click here and set a millisecond value. So if you have a lot of plugins in your session, you can make the song start at a later time. So for example, if you set this to 20 milliseconds, the track won't start for 20 milliseconds, and then you can, you know, compensate that way. Okay, but let's turn on the effects, and I'm going to record a nonsense melody into the track just to show you how to do it. So let's turn on our effects, make sure they're on. All right, so now go to song mode, and I like to record audio into playlist as an audio clip. That's how I record, personally. Now also, if you're doing harmonies and different things which require a lot of the same kind of vocal take over and over and over again, I highly suggest you turn on loop recording. And if you want to just do freestyle just to get like the best recording, I suggest loop recording. Loop recording is right here. Just activate that and it will play all the way through or play through your selected area and just keep looping. That will help you if you have to do a hook with a lot of different takes, but it's like the same words, just a different note or a different style. So that way you can have it multiple takes. So let's record loop mode and I'll do two nonsense melodies to show you how to work with loop mode. So let's, and again, the only thing about loop mode is that it creates hard cuts at the end. So if you're singing kind of over into the next bar, it will cut it into a new audio clip. So if you want to avoid that, I would highly suggest turning loop mode off or leaving another section, highlighting more section to tell it to keep recording, or else it will stop at wherever the MIDI stops, okay? So let's go back to the beginning, hit record, make sure your track is highlighted, go to your microphone, make sure it's armed for recording, make sure your effects are on, I almost forgot. And we're gonna hit record, audio into playlist is an audio clip.
Yes, live by your own ground, I'ma get it anyway, okay, and I'ma ride harder. I'ma be turned up, never turned down. Be brave, no, don't, hear it, being afraid, blue face, oh, that girl. I'ma get the bag, I'ma turn it up, I'ma get the bag, I'ma turn it up. Now with me sway, yeah,
get the gist. Let me turn this off. So again, that was nonsense melody. I call that placeholder melody for when you're writing songs. So you can see they're grayed out. So you might hit play and go, where are my audio recordings? You want to click the mute button up here and unmute it.
I'ma be lit, I'ma be gone, I'ma be turned up, never turned on.
See, when you loop record, let me zoom in. I didn't really loop record that much, but you can see it started a new audio clip. So if I were to continue saying a word at the end on the right side, it would cut it and create a new audio clip, and that can cause phase issues, clicks and pop issues you don't want. So that's how you use a loop recording, and that's how you record in FL Studio. And when you loop record, it's going to add these little subgroups, so it keeps everything contained. The only thing is, you know, I wish it was a cleaner process for recording. Again, we all have our wish list for FL Studio, but it's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to continue the FL Studio series, go to BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.